Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Gil from Black Hole Comics, and today we're going to be doing a review on the McFarlane Mortal Kombat 11 Spawn action figure. This guy is awesome. Gotta say, pretty excited about this thing. It's a pretty hard and sought-after figure. First articulated Spawn figure that we've had in 15 years, so that's pretty amazing. I'm going to be getting into a review, or kind of a comparison of the two. This and then the figure that they released 15 years ago, the 10th anniversary. Just a quick disclaimer, this does not come with the figure. It's part of the Mezco Green Lantern. I kind of dremeled it out a bit to make it fit the peg. Okay, so we're going to quickly go over some of the detail. There goes the head sculpt. It's done really well. The cape, the chains. Would have been nice if it would have been real metal, but hey. It's fine. The sculpt work. The gauntlet. He does come with the sword. This is his only pack-in accessory besides the little stand, which I tossed that. Don't need that. Cape has really nice deco, sculpt, paint. Look at the washes. Looks great. Definitely a cloth cape would have been nice, but I know that we're not going to get that for 20 bucks. Pouches and the boot. So I'm sure you've already seen other reviews on this guy and the articulation. He can look that far up, that far down, not a whole lot. He can go this much forward, this far forward with the top diaphragm joint. If you use both, you could go that far forward and as far as back. This much with just the top diaphragm joint, and then with both he could go really far back. So believe it or not, he could get more range. There is a mod, and I will be making a separate video on some little mods you could do to get better articulation. His arms can go that far up, more than 90 degrees, which is nice. Bicep swivel, double jointed elbows. The hands, they can remove. The peg should not come out with it. But it can go up, down, and rotate. Here at the waist, you can't kick out that much. Kick forward and out at an angle. That much. And that far back. The crotch area is a nice soft pliable plastic, which is nice. It's not solid. That's what allows for the nice range. Double jointed knees. No boot cut. Can go down, up. There's a toe hinge. And a little bit of ankle pivot. Yeah, quite a bit in there. So again, this is the kind of flaming fireball effect from the Mezco Green Lantern. Only it's really simple. Just all you gotta do is just dremel it out a bit and it fits easy peasy on the peg. So this head is an extra Mezco Green Lantern John Stewart head. I feel like it doubles as an Al Simmons head. It works great. This is definitely something that you could get to fit on. I just have it sitting on there just chilling, but you could take the peg out, put in that head sculpt, add some hot glue, and you're golden. I will forever love this figure. This is the 10th anniversary figure. I got it just a few years ago. My buddy bought it for me for my birthday, and my brother, actually the same birthday, gave me the translucent version. So yeah, as you can see, this is more of the classic look, more of a modern look. This definitely blows the old one out of the water as far as articulation goes. This has amazing sculpt, amazing paint, deco, all that stuff. It reminds you of like the classic Toy Biz stuff. But this is modern figures right here. Upgraded, you know, buck, articulation, all that stuff. I really do love this figure. It's quickly rose up and it's like neck and neck with this figure because this will always have a special place in my heart. It's definitely the unicorn of my collection. So to stick with the whole entire comparison, size comparisons, all that stuff. Got SH Figure Arts Trunks, then 6-inch scale, so way smaller. And since I was talking about Green Lantern, here goes a Hal Jordan because my John Stewart is currently on a flight stand and don't want to take him off right now. Just being lazy. Here he goes next to a Hal Jordan. So there he goes. And as you can see, a bit taller. A bit taller. Here goes his buddy from Mortal Kombat. This is the Mortal Kombat 3 Sub-Zero, but actually in 11 they team up. He's buddies with Sub-Zero and Scorpion. So, damn, he's a bit taller as well as the Storm Collectibles. That's surprising. Did not think he was going to be that much taller. Okay, the last action figure line that I'll use is Marvel Legends. And as you can see, Deadpool is as well smaller. So everybody is smaller than Spawn. Way bigger than everybody else. There he goes, guys. Hopefully you liked this review. Hopefully you found it informative. Please like, share, and subscribe. Make sure to check me out at Black Hole Comics on Instagram. Make sure to check out my podcast Instagram over at The Geek Out Show. And you can find us on Stitcher, iTunes, anywhere that you can find podcasts, honestly. Make sure to stay geeked up and geek out. But that